Hey guys, welcome back to our channel. It's the Parentrepreneurs here, back for our Sunday recording.
Yep.
For today's topic, we'll be talking about...
So for today's topic, we're going to be talking about how Camille got scammed.
How Camille got scammed, thanks.
So this was back in the days in high school, and we'll talk about that. But last week, we put in a poll on Instagram where it was, you know, is it necessary to go to college,
mm-hmm.
or how she got scammed.
Right. Yeah.
So we'll talk about that today, and hopefully you guys learned something new, because this is very, very prominent business model, and a lot of people get lured into this,
mm-hmm.
not really knowing what it is.
Right. And so just a bit of a disclaimer as well, this is our own experience, and we just want to have this as a warning to people to just be aware and to be cautious of who they encounter with, or if someone just suddenly comes up to you, what to look for, mm-hmm. and when to know to stay away. First, please subscribe to our channel. The button is below. Also, like our Facebook page and our Instagram and
yep.
our YouTube, and hopefully bring us up on our social media algorithm.
Yep.
And yeah, thanks for tuning in as always. If you have any suggestions for future videos, please put them down in the comments below. And yeah, we're gonna get started.
Yeah, let's go.
So first things first, as most of you who know us, we've been together since we were in high school. So we've endured a lot together. And this is gonna be our story time of our first MLM experience.
Yeah.
And how would you wanna talk about it?
Well, we can talk about how we first got introduced to it, because
yeah.
back in the days, and I think when we were in high school, we had a friend that came up to us,
mm-hmm.
and they were like, hey, you know, I heard that you're really into self-motivation, self-improvement,
yeah.
Come to this event,
mm-hmm.
and Camille and I were like, okay, you know, we like that kind of stuff, so let's take a look to see what they have to offer.
Right.
And we did this, I think... It might have been around, was it summertime or something like that? Or
was it winter.
Was it winter?
It was cold, yeah, I remember.
Okay,
it being
yeah.
cold, yeah.
Yeah, so it was winter time. And from there, one of my friends is like, okay, you know, meet at this place. And from there, you know, we went in. The house was very warmer. It's like, you know, it builds trust, right? And there was a bunch of people there that we saw that were looking to also improve themselves. And there was the speaker. He converted a lot of those people
mm-hmm.
to be part of this system.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, so for those who don't know what an MLM is,
yeah.
an MLM is a, yeah, like Mick said, it's a system
mm-hmm.
where people basically acquire other people, and in that they get a return of investment, I guess is what you would say. And it starts off with usually one person being at the top, while they, mm-hmm. when they acquire people, then it builds up the foundation, so it ends up being a pyramid scheme. So
yeah.
MLM is kind of like similar to a pyramid scheme, or almost the same as a pyramid scheme.
Yeah, it was basically
mm-hmm.
like the wording, or the what it stands for, MLM, multi-level marketing. So
multi-levels.
You have multi-levels. Yeah, so you have multi-levels of, you know, either a person or a company that, like, basically it's kind of like pyramid scheme set up.
After the whole presentation was done, they approached us asking if we were interested, and of course me, I'm being so optimistic all the time, I'm thinking, oh, this is such a great idea.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
But then McFrancis, he's always the risk reward type of person,
yeah.
and he just had this gut feeling that we shouldn't pursue this, because he was already familiar with pyramid schemes and MLMs
a little bit, but
yeah,
not
like
too
you,
much.
You knew. I
yeah.
didn't even know that existed
yeah,
at the time.
At the time.
So
and the thing too is that when you have this kind of like gut feeling,
mm-hmm.
well, for me, like, I always trust it, because like the presentation, the way they made it sound, that, you know, it's gonna be easy, that you're gonna be driving a nice car,
yeah.
you're gonna be having a nice house, you're gonna be basically, you're gonna have everything in life. So just the way that they described it, I'm
mm-hmm.
just like, that's
too good to be
too
true.
Too good to be true. There's
yeah.
no way you could do that. And especially coming from my background, that in order to be successful, you gotta put time into it
mm-hmm.
and work really hard, so
mm-hmm.
that, you know, the results that you put in is based on your work ethic.
Right. So the second time we got exposed to an MLM was actually, it's kind of like you think about it and you're just like, wow, I was so naive and
yeah.
so like... Anyways, the second time we got encountered by an MLM was through my auntie and my uncle, actually. And we go to church every Sunday,
mm-hmm.
and they told us to join in on this great opportunity. So again, we were encountered with this, you know, you're gonna have a good life if you pursue this opportunity, right? Mm-hmm. So we're like, okay, well, it's my auntie and my uncle, like, I love them, they're my family, we trust them.
Yeah.
So I'm like, okay, we'll see what this is all about. And then the pastor was actually the one who would conduct the service every Sunday. So again, I'm thinking, oh yeah, it's a pastor, like, we can trust this guy, like, he's teaching us the word of God, you know what I mean?
Yeah.
So he came to us at my house. So I was living at my parents at the time, and Francis was still my boyfriend at the time. And he came over and he did this whole presentation about what this business was all about. And I was thinking again, I'm like, this sounds familiar. Almost too familiar, you know what I mean? So he was saying like, okay, yeah, if you do this, all you have to do is just get people to join this business and you'll get a lot of money. Mm-hmm. You'll get a good house, you'll have a nice car, etc., etc. And I'm just like, okay, yeah, this is definitely, like, you know. But at the same time, I'm like, but he's a pastor, you know, like, there was a battle in between myself and, you know, my heart and my mind kind of thing. And then he was saying, if you're interested, like, it's only $500 to join in.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, okay, $500, that's not bad.
Yeah.
Right? But at the same time, I'm in high school, I didn't have money. And after the presentation was done, he basically said, oh, okay, yeah, if you're interested, like, you can come meet with people who have done this very successfully afterwards. And then he was talking about how these people have acquired Lexuses, like, beautiful cars, like, luxurious cars. And that kind of, like, sold me. I was like, oh, I want to get a luxury car. You know what I mean?
Yeah. Especially at that young
age. Yeah, especially at that age. I'm like, if I do well in this, like, this is going to be great. Like, I'm going to have a Lexus. I'm going to have a lot of money.
Yeah.
Yeah, so that was the end of that. And I actually asked my dad to pay the $500 up front for me because I didn't have money at the time. I didn't even have a job. And I guess that's another thing, too, was I was vulnerable at the time. Hi guys, feature Camille butting in here. Sorry, I was editing this video and I realized that we missed a really important thing or topic to discuss, and that was the fact that this pastor used his authority and his power to manipulate people within the organization, and that is not okay. So I just wanted you guys to not take this topic really lightly. This is actually a very serious matter. The fact that he can manipulate people with his words, and he was somebody that had, you know, an influence on us because he was a pastor and he was supposedly spreading the word of God and all that stuff. So I don't want this to be slipped by. This is not okay. And I want you guys just to be aware and do your research before, you know, jumping into any business decision that you may make in the future. But nevertheless, we've learned our lesson. I've learned my lesson, and we are just careful all around now and just have your guard up all the time. So I just wanted to jump in here quickly because I feel that this is really important to talk about, and never ever let anyone take advantage of you, no matter who it is. Always stand up for yourself. So thanks. Because I didn't have a job and I needed money, and in order to, you know, make ends meet or even to get the things that I wanted, I needed to have a job, and I thought of this as a job. So then the second meeting came around. We met with a bunch of these people who are successful in the business, and they have Lexuses, and they drove them to the meeting. So I was just like, oh yeah, we're gonna get into this real good, right? Thinking that, you know, I'm gonna be just as successful as them. But little did I know, it was actually a lot more work. And just the way that they did their presentation as well during that second meeting was they were pitching like, oh yeah, it's super easy, like, all you have to do is meet with all your friends and family, list them all down and talk to them one-on-one and try to get them into this business and you'll be really successful. And I was like, okay, so this seems really easy.
Yeah.
Right? But I ended up just not pursuing it because they said, like, for every meeting, you would have to put up an upfront payment to meet with these people to kind of mentor you and to coach you into doing better. And I was just like, why do I have to pay people to meet for me to be successful? You know what I mean? Like, shouldn't it be free? But yeah, anyways, I didn't pursue going with them anymore, and I actually stopped doing it. And then that's when we realized, like, yeah, this was another MLM scam. So I lost $500.
Yeah, and just when Camille was talking about it, like at the time, like she had to make that mistake so she can learn from it. Because if you didn't make that mistake, I'm sure you're gonna you're gonna make it you're gonna make that mistake in the future.
And
I was gonna say too is like I was there in the presentation when the pastor came to the house. And I knew it was already an MLM that they were saying that, yeah, you know, you can basically sell products, and with that products, I think it was like skincare, but the way to actually make money is to get people in this business.
Right.
So I'm just like, ding, MLM, pyramid scheme. But to be honest, a lot of people are at the top, are very successful, but most of the people that are the bottom are the ones that are not making money.
Yeah, it's true.
So that's how it works, right? So the very top are the ones that are making a lot of money. And there's so many businesses out there that has that same business model.
And it works.
It works. That's why people are doing it. It works. But to be honest, is that very ethical? Because a lot of people are, you know, getting lured in these businesses
and wasting money
and it's not actually providing value to the market. And what we believe in is you have to provide value in the market, and when you provide value in the market, then the byproduct would be money.
From this experience, we want to share what to watch out for. So one of the main things is when someone approaches you, is they say like, oh, they're are you interested in a business opportunity?
You want to be your own CEO.
Yeah, exactly. And when someone comes to you like that, you kind of have to question, like, what does this business opportunity mean? You have to ask questions. Like, don't be afraid to ask questions. Yeah. Ask them how they make money. That's, like, number one. If they can't tell you, then it's probably an MLM.
MLM. Or if it's, like, complicated, they're saying that, you know, you can make money this way, you can make money that way. And it's just this, like, no, kind of like clear line how to actually make money, then you definitely know that something is not right, and you gotta trust your gut feeling.
Or another thing is they ask you for a meeting, like they want to set a meeting with you one-on-one. That's another thing that is kind of like, okay, why do they need to meet me one-on-one? Why can't they just tell me on the spot?
You know what I mean?
So that's, those are things to watch out for when someone approaches you for a business opportunity. Also, if they ask for payment, like an investment from your part to join this business opportunity. It's, if you think about it, like a job, you don't need to pay to be a part of a job. You send in your resume, you go through the interview process, and then you get hired on and you have compensation for it, right? So if someone is telling you like, oh, you need to invest money into building this business, then that's when you know, like, that's an MLM.
MLM, and especially if you're not doing it, because like when we started the business, we definitely had to put our own money in, but we know where our money is going. It's not like where you put your money in and basically you don't know what's gonna happen to it. So basically, like, the return on investment doesn't make sense when you give it to somebody else, or you use that same money and you invest it in yourself, and from there be able to, you know, actually create your own business and provide value to the market. We'll talk about how MLMs has changed and has evolved, and now it's going to the digital world, so basically going online. And we noticed this because we helped a bunch of other businesses with their marketing, with basically advertising, graphic designing, all that stuff with Katigbak Technologies. So there's a bunch of people that already came to us asking for help because they have a digital marketing business, and I'm like, you have a digital marketing business and you need help from us? And I'm like, that doesn't make sense, right? And from there, what I realized is that, okay, this is a new way of how these people are operating, this business are operating.
And just decided to join us.
So anyway, with this business, basically what's happening is people are promising that you can have your online business, and it's gonna be very, very easy to do that. And they put a system in place so that a regular person can start up their online business, right? And from there, what's happening is a lot of people that have a 9-to-5 job, mm-hmm. that want a way out, is they look at this kind of place, or they look at this business opportunity, and with this business opportunity, they want to try it. And the upfront cost is pretty much the same thing, where, okay, you paid this amount of money, mm-hmm. and with this amount of money, you know, we'll give you all the tools
yeah.
to make your online business work. Mm-hmm. And with that, what's happening is, you know, people are doing it, but they don't really teach you the way to do it.
That's why they're asking the techniques,
the strategies,
yeah.
technologies. Mm-hmm. Basically, they just give you this package. It's like, oh, here you go. And the way they disguise it is that they say that, hey, you know, you'll have a product that you're selling, mm-hmm. and with this product, and one of them was, I think it was like a water filter.
Yeah.
And with that water filter, they were saying that, oh yeah, you know, that's the byproduct to make money online, but to actually make the real money
is to acquire
other people.
Yeah.
And just hearing that, that's what MLM is, right? Mm-hmm. It's a multi-level marketing where it's a pyramid scheme, basically,
yeah.
where you're getting, you're recruiting people, mm-hmm. so that you can make money off those people as well.
Yeah.
And to be honest, you know, that business model really works, but for us, we don't believe in that business model because mm-hmm. we want to provide value to the market.
Exactly.
Yeah.
I want to talk about what real marketing agencies do. So when you are, say for example, you're a small business owner and you need help with marketing and advertising, the number one thing you need to look for when it comes to a real digital marketing agency is evidence and proof. If they cannot provide proof to you that they got a certain result, then I wouldn't trust that digital marketing agency.
Yeah. And also too, like when I was talking to those people that I was helping out,
yeah.
Most of the time they were saying that, you know, their Facebook ad accounts mm-hmm. are getting banned, so how do I unban it? And if you're doing something that Facebook doesn't like,
yeah.
then you know that you're doing something wrong, so you know that not to pursue that, right?
Mm-hmm. And you don't want to be in that situation where your Facebook ad account gets banned, because if you're a digital marketing agency, that's like your bread and butter.
Mm-hmm.
Like, you need to have that always working and always, you know, functioning at its best. Another thing to look for with a real digital marketing agency is that they're able to provide you their techniques and how they do things, their procedures, their processes. So if a company cannot tell you how they get leads to you, then you know that there's something wrong with that.
Mm-hmm.
Another thing to look out for is basically jargon. If a digital marketing agency does not tell you like specific words, or if they are not able to comprehend certain words like copywriting, if they
yeah.
cannot tell you what SEO is, if they cannot tell you what Facebook ads are, if they can't tell you, you know, Google ads, all of those jargon for marketing at all, be very aware, because that's basically what marketing agencies do, is that they provide copywriting, they provide graphic design, creatives, right? They use programs such as Adobe, Photoshop, Illustrator, all of those things. Also applying
CMS, content management system for web designs and stuff like that.
Yeah, so they know stuff like that, web design, they know WordPress, they know
Shopify,
they know, what's that other one? Drupal. Oh,
Drupal? Drupal? Drupal.
Okay. Yeah, so those things are products or services that marketing agencies should know. So those are things that you need to watch out for, and you need to ask questions when you're encountering a real digital marketing agency, or if you're looking for a real digital marketing agency. And with that, I just want to say thank you guys for holding on for this long video. Also, we have our digital marketing agency, Katigbak Technologies, if you guys ever need any marketing advice, if you guys need any marketing help, advertising help, graphic design, SEO, like I said, we can do all of that for you. So if you're interested, our website will be down below, and we love helping small businesses and providing value to you guys.
Yeah.
So yeah, thank you guys for tuning in. This is the end of our video. We talked about our first MLM experience, our second MLM experience, and what to look out for when you're encountered by somebody who doesn't have all the right intentions, and also what to look out for when you're looking for someone who is legitimate and who provides real value. So yeah, we will post another poll out on our Instagram story asking you guys what you want to hear from us. And also, don't forget to like, subscribe, like, subscribe our channel, our YouTube, our Instagram. It would help us out a lot. And until next time, we'll see you guys next week.
Next week.
Happy Thanksgiving, by the way.
Happy Thanksgiving. Yeah. Say happy Thanksgiving, Ben.
Happy Thanksgiving.
Yeah, happy Thanksgiving.
Okay, bye.
See ya.
Bye.